Hey everybody, my name's Tyler Watson, your Las Vegas and Henderson Realtor. This is Tour Time with Tyler, and welcome to Amigo Trail. Let's check out this one. But again, before we do, right here is the link to my resale app. Up above is the link to my new construction website. You can go to either one of those links or scan the QR code with your mobile phone and it will take you directly to them. Completely free to use. Let's check out this one. So we are over here at Amigo Trail. It is a new construction DR Horton build, but before we talk about it, if you are thinking about buying new, you wanna buy new, you are considering buying new, call me right away. Call me before you call the builder, before you email him, before you go and see the models in person. I need to go with you the first time if you want representation, because the sales associates actually represent the builder. They don't represent you. So if you want representation, give me a call. All of my info is down in the description as well as the pinned comment. And fun fact, as the buyer, you don't pay the realtor commission. The builder does. So one more reason to give me a call. I'm going to spin around and throw a map up of where we are today. We are in the south of the valley, pretty close to we are in Henderson, but pretty close to Inspirata. But a little bit about this one. They're going to be triplexes and fourplexes, but basically what it's going to be is it's going to be a 1417, a 1319, and a 1417. Now, if they're the fourplex, the 1319 will also be in the middle. So there's just two models here at this community. This one, again, DR Horton build. This one we are looking at today is the 1417. It's three bed, 2.5 bath. It does have a two-car garage. It's on the other side. Now, I know people ask me all the time to try to find new construction under $400,000. You are looking at a $384,990 new construction build. And this basically comes with everything. It comes with all the appliances. I'm going to show you there's just a couple things that they changed in the model, but basically this home, as you see it, is what you are going to get. Now, a couple of the lots might have like a $5,000 premium. Just gonna show you, like this one will 100% because it's on the beltway, but most of them, that price is going to be the price. But again, if you have any questions, all my info is down below. If you could do me a huge favor, please hit that like button. Again, if you want to stay up to date on tours, make sure to subscribe. But coming on in, it is very open in here. So you have your living, I'm gonna come over here just to spin. You have your kitchen, and then you have your dining. So it's one big, big open space. I noticed this when I was just filming the other one. These are pretty cool. These are your toggles for your lights. I feel like it's very European. I guess one of the nice things is they're easy to hit. They're really wide. You're not fumbling around for them. But I noticed they're doing it on all of the lighting switches. But again, we have our living area. And if you don't know what that is, that actually is a high pressure fire suppression system. There's basically a sprinkler in the ceiling. So again, living, and then we move into dining. You could even get more of a rectangular table and bring it out a bit. It might get a little tight right here, but you could definitely fit a bigger table in here. And then if we spin, we get to our kitchen. So you have the island, and like I said, basically what you see is what you get. You might have a different flooring color. You might have different countertop color and different cabinet color, but that is it. It's going to look like this. You're going to get stainless steel appliances. You're going to get the washer and dryer, which is pretty nice. Again, under $390,000. So if we come on in to our island, you have your stainless steel dishwasher. You have your stainless steel undermounted sink. If you don't know what that is a reverse osmosis filter. So basically bottled water comes out of it. There's some filters underneath the sink. Here's your view. So you're basically right in the middle of everything. If we spin back around, we have our 36-inch uppers. You have your element heating, there's four of them. You have your stainless steel microwave. And what I thought was cool is it actually vents outside. It doesn't recirculate, but again, not soft close. If you need soft close, always go to Home Depot or Lowe's and grab some hinges and switch them out. We have our stainless steel refrigerator, and then you have a little nook right here. I'm gonna be honest, it is a little tight, but there is a lot of counter space, so I feel like maybe a stand mixer or a coffee little nook. And then you do have some more storage up in here. Right here, you have your pantry, and it's actually a pretty decent sized pantry. I guess even if you needed to add an extra shelf, you 100% could, but the biggest difference between the model and what you will get Again, they're gonna paint some walls and they have speakers. So you won't get the speaker, you won't get the green wall. All the walls are gonna be white and no speaker. But basically this is the home, which is kind of nice because I know people always say, oh, we go see the models. And there's 100,000, if not more, of options. So here is our downstairs water closet, our powder room, and you have your pedestal sink. I'm gonna be honest, it's not so bad in here. I wish this light was maybe a little bit more centered or second light. It does get a little dim in here because it looks like the ceiling is only 7 feet tall. You can see right here what I'm talking about, but it's not too bad. I've been in some models where it's almost like a cave in the powder room. Right here, we really have the Harry Potter room. So underneath the stairs, you have storage. No light though, so you're gonna probably need a flashlight if you put stuff back in the back, but it is nice that you just have additional storage. If we go ahead and head on up. Again, if you have any questions about anything I'm saying regarding this home, a different new construction build, a resale, you need to speak with a lender and see what you could potentially qualify for, give me a call. All of my contact is down in the description as well as the pinned comment. Upstairs. So kind of cool, we have a loft. Oh, I feel like we need another light just because it is a little dim. It's only like 4:15, 4:30 in the afternoon in May. So you're definitely gonna want a lamp in here, but it is a pretty nice size loft. You could easily get a couch up here. You could probably even throw a TV up here, but I feel like a lot of people are gonna use this as a reading space or just fun space. If we spin directly around, we get two linens, and then I'm guessing washer and dryer. Yep. Now there is a light in here. Right there's the switch, they just don't have it on, but these will be included. Now I don't know if they're gonna be Whirlpool brand or what, but you will get the washer and dryer, which just adds to the fact that, again, under 400,000, you're getting all the appliances, which is not common. Pretty neat. We'll save the primary for last, but coming on into bedroom number one. It's okay size. I feel like it's just a tiny bit bigger than the last model, but I might be wrong. We'll have to see. You could definitely fit a full-size bed in here. You could fit a small nightstand and maybe a little desk, but I know when I was just filming the other one, the bed's gonna come out pretty far. So if you put a dresser in here, it's gonna get tight. Excuse me, it's gonna get tight. But all in all, not too bad. If we spin around, I will show you the closet. So you do get a two-door closet. If you need more hanging space because you can't fit a dresser in here, always move the bar and shelf up, add a second one, and you've doubled your hanging space. If we come on over here, we get to bedroom number two. A little bit better representation so you can see the bed. Now, a full-size bed, again, would fit. You could probably get a little bit smaller of a nightstand and a desk, maybe nightstand on this side, desk on that side. But you could see, if you were to put a dresser in here, it wouldn't be so bad since it's just a full-size bed. It could be doable, but if you start getting a little bit bigger of a bed, it will get a little bit on the tighter side. Same closet. So these are just mirrored image rooms. And then right here we have our upstairs bath. So you have your toilet. It's kind of funny how close it is to the tub. I feel like 4 inches that way would be perfect because it is like a very nice size, but it is a little bit on the smaller size bathroom. You have your tub shower combo. Now this is going to be a fiberglass composite material. There's your shower head, your valve, and your tub filler. Again, like I always say, one of the nice things about the composite is it's easier to clean than grout. I know a lot of people do like tile. And if we spin around, same exact thing as on the other one. Actually, this feels a little bit bigger. The other one had a smaller vanity. So a little bit bigger vanity on this one. You're only going to get one sink. Two is not an option, but I know some people do like the extra counter space, especially since you can't have a second portion in here. There's only one door. I feel like most people are gonna like the single sink. Coming on into our master, our primary suite. Nice size. So king size bed, you have two dressers. You could put a chair over here. I noticed what's interesting is the, what was that one? The 1319. So this one's 1417. The 1319 had quite a bit bigger primary bedroom, but I know the closet was pretty small, but this one's pretty good size. You have your dresser. I'm gonna come over here just so you can see again. It's a nice size bedroom. I'm not calling it small by any means. But if we spin directly around, we have our primary bathroom. Decent size vanity. It's actually funny, I think the vanity in the secondary bathroom is bigger, but you have your vanity. Again, they're gonna, if you want soft closing cabinets, go to Lowe's. And then you have your toilet and you have your shower only. So bench, shelf. And then if we spin directly behind us, let's see how big this closet is. Now, would this bother you, having your closet directly in the bathroom? Because I know some people don't want to have steam constantly rolling into the closet. It's pretty far away, but let me know down in the comments below. And we have our closet. I'm gonna be honest, it is on the smaller side. Most people are probably gonna need more hanging space and wanna move up and add a second one. And maybe just leave this portion right here, that length, in case they have longer either gowns or suits or stuff like that. So at least it won't just hang and hit the either ground or second bar. But pretty nice. Again, we're under 390, we're at 385. Hard to beat. And it includes the appliances. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Again, if you have any questions about anything I've said regarding this one, a different new one, a resale, you need to talk with a lender. All my info is down in the description as well as the pinned comment. If you could do me a huge favor and hit that like button. Also, make sure to subscribe. And as always, thanks for tagging along with Tour Time with Tyler. Stay safe out there, everyone.